Now, we're just kidding back there, folks. We love you dearly, you know that. We're all going to be at the big party at the Sheraton Saturday night a week, you know, and we'll get a little hammered and talk about this.
Well, that's a leftover from the Rivera show, that just...
What's that?
About drugs, heroin, all that stuff.
There are no leftovers from the Geraldo show. Geraldo clears the whole rack every night. Here. Yes, sir. Okay, we're with Kathleen Sullivan. Argus Hamilton will be here in a bit, and Dottie's here right now from somewhere in the fair state of Pennsylvania. Hi, Dottie, how are you?
Tom, you don't remember, it's from Collegeville. Are you going to be at the airport?
At the Collegeville airport?
No.
Oh, you mean to pick you up to go to the party?
Right.
I promised somebody else, Dottie.
Oh, no.
Don't hate me.
I don't.
No. I'll tell you what, you're the first caller, though, so you get the Les McCann CD.
I am excited. I really can't. I watched the show last night, and I wanted that. I was going to get it today. I'm glad I didn't.
Nope, because you're going to get it tomorrow. The CD.
No comment.
I understand. Say hi to Kathleen Sullivan.
You know what else?
What's
last
that?
Last night you mentioned that you were, it was kind of like you put your hands up and said, hey, hold the ties. I hope you got the one I sent.
Tell me where you sent it from.
I sent it from Collegeville. It came from Strawbridge and Clothiers department store.
You mean the Penn State tie?
No.
Which one?
It's got a train on it.
Oh, the train tie is downstairs. It's
okay.
It's coming up next week, I swear.
Okay, well, I'll be recording it.
Okay, Dottie.
My mom's going to be 87, and she's waiting to see it.
Okay. In fact, Dottie, tomorrow night is train tie night, I swear.
All right.
Set them VCRs, okay?
I'll set them.
All right. Now, Kathleen Sullivan is here, and she'd love to say hi to you. Say hi to Kathleen, Dottie.
Hi, Dottie. Why do I get this feeling that you have a crush on Tom? Is
Kathleen,
that true?
It's from the 1960s, I hate to tell you.
The crushes or the tie?
You know, if this stuff would have been on the CBS Morning News, you know, instead of all that other junk.
And they would have three more affiliates there.
Yeah. Well, they're going UHF over there. Anyway, Dottie, what's your question for Kathleen?
My question, first of all, a comment. Kathleen, you look fantastic.
Thanks.
Yeah,
thanks.
Fantastic, and I've been pulling for you. I used to use Weight Watchers, and I want you to know that you've done a great job, and you've done Weight Watchers a great, great promotion.
Oh, Dottie, thank you.
You look great. Thanks. Now, I have a question. I've done Weight Watchers before, and I just wanted to know, lots of friends that I know do it, and when you get to know the program, sometimes you can work around it to cheat a little bit.
That's what everyone thinks. And then what happens? Boom!
Yeah. Yeah. And Tom, I'm not fat.
I didn't say a word, Dottie. No. I'm just biding my time, Dottie.
Okay, I just want you
I'm
to
just know. Happy you're not teed off about the party, you know. But anyway, to talk to Kathleen more about the Weight Watchers, because
okay,
what we're here to do is build up these franchises.
I just wanted to know, did she stick to it, and, really strict diet, and you didn't cheat and try and work around it?
Of course you cheat. Of course you cheat a little bit, but I know how to cheat. I've learned how to cheat. But you know, like Ivy at the Shore? The Ivy at the Shore has this unbelievable, like, I cannot pass on that vanilla bean ice cream, and I know I'm not supposed to have it, but they just take these little teeny spoons, and they just eat little teeny spoons and four spoons, and I push away. Mm-hmm. So I kind of build it in. But you learn to, you can't, I've been on it 6 months or 7 months now, so you have to, you do every once in a while, but you know how to regroup.
Dottie, you got to treat yourself once in a while, kid, because I'll tell you, this ain't a rehearsal, Dottie. Life, you know what I mean?
I know.
Got to enjoy. Hey, hot fudge sundaes are a gift from God. Dottie, colortinis are a gift from God.
Colortinis?
Yeah.
What are they?
It's just gin on the rocks or vodka on the rocks. Yeah, very simple drink, colortini. Have a few and colors appear.
Okay, Tom.
Dottie, we're going to put this CD in the mail, and I'll have the train tie on the air for you tomorrow night.
Now, listen, do they need my address?
Yeah, but we're going to put you on hold, and we're going to get it from you.
Okay, and I just want to tell you, don't forget, if you get stood up, call me. I'll be up there at the airport.
Dottie, leave their phone number here. You never know.
Okay.
All right, Dottie.
You know, Tom, she raises an interesting point. Are you single?
We're not here to talk about me. We're here to talk about you.
I was just wondering because she's obviously interested in you, and I was just wondering if
she's a viewer of the program who likes the work that we do. She was interested in
you. It doesn't sound like her work.
And she was certainly interested in you. I mean, she wanted to know if you could cheat a little bit, and you told her that you go and you drop the name of the restaurant, which you'll probably be there tonight, you know. And
I'm sorry, I missed you
though. You know, I was with Kissinger at Ivy of the Shore.
We never hit that restaurant.
Did you go out with him for dinner and stuff?
No, we had a Tuesday date where every Tuesday we'd have lunch at some restaurant in New York.
He likes the babes, I hear. Is that
true? We'd have a blast because everyone would think we were having an affair. So we had so much fun making everybody think we were having an affair, and then we'd talk, find out stuff, and he'd find out stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Janet in Red Bank, Tennessee. Hello.
Hi, Tom.
Janet, how you been?
I've been fine. Miss talking to you in a while.
Oh, my
One
goodness.
Of your producers told me to get a life, so I stopped calling.
And by the way, it ain't like the production team is on Sunset Boulevard for the conga line every night, okay? You know, most nights we stop at St. Charles Borromeo and light candles. Yeah, and we're not talking for our careers. Anyway, Janet, say hi to Kathleen Sullivan. She's right here.
Well, Kathleen, I think you look lovely, but I'll tell you quite frankly.
Oh, here comes the hair.
As talented and well-spoken as you are, you could put a bag over your head, and I'd still turn in to watch you. I still remember the Olympic coverage stuff that you did.
Fabulous. Emmy award-winning stuff, yep. Great stuff.
I think you're one of the best people who's ever been in the business because you obviously have a brain. It doesn't hurt that you're good-looking. I should be so ugly. I don't see the fuss. I'm tired of these really pretty people,
Janet,
who haven't got anything between the right ear and the left ear except air.
Janet, for one second, my dear, hang on because I got a commercial, and we won't. You'll stay right there, and you and Kathleen can pursue this, okay? And we'll, during the next minute and a half or so, we'll get the paper bag out. we'll be right back after these messages. Now, Janet, you were saying that what was it? You're sick of all these pretty faces on TV.
I'm tired of people who look good, who do not know the English language, who can't pronounce things correctly, who get paid enormous sums of money, and haven't got a clue as to what they're talking about.
Well, you know, Janet, in all honesty, I've got to tell you, when I first went on the air, that's what everyone said about me.
Well,
I mean, you know, and I mean, in 80 and 82 and 84 and 87, you know, they constantly would say that.
Yeah.
And I think sometimes that, you know, like, you know, Joan, for instance, Joan London's a very pretty girl, and she's very smart. She's also smart to know what area she's going to delve in and where she's going to go. She's smart enough to know where she's going to be an expert and where she isn't, you know. And so it's always kind of hard to tell, like, what pretty face, you know.
Gotcha.
Look at you.
Gotcha.
I'm not asking anybody to be an expert. It's just, if you've got someone you're talking to, try and pronounce the name right.
Oh, yeah.
You know, if you're talking about some place on the other side of the world, try and get the pronunciation right. Just little things like that.
Yeah. Like, you know, I was watching the news out here one day, and I won't mention this woman's name because I'm sure that she's been corrected, but she pronounced the capital of Colombia as Bogota. You know, and I thought to myself, by the time you get to L.A. anchoring for a network-owned station, you ought to know that it ain't Bogota, you know? Your point is well made, Janet. Was there anything else?
Nothing much. I just keep enjoying what you're doing.
Thanks, ma'am. I appreciate that.
You keep doing the good work.
Isn't it wonderful to see him again? I just love watching you again, Tom.
Well, thank you.
I really do.
Thank you.
Well,
you mean during my return?
Pennsylvania, and I was an old Snyder fan in Pennsylvania for years, so, you know.
I know.
Transplanted Pennsylvanians are very happy to see somebody civilized.
Janet, I'm glad you called. Thank you.
Take care.
All right, bye-bye now. You know, some years back, I worked for ABC Radio. You know, people talk about comebacks. I'm sure you don't feel like you're away. I've never felt that I was away from it, you know. But I remember going on one night with Bob Costas when he was doing the later series, and he would bring you on for a couple of segments, and I'd been off network television for, I guess, 7 or 8 years. And he asked me a question I'm going to ask you, because your talents are considerable. I mean, you caught my eye on CNN when you anchored on that network, and you certainly caught not only my eye, but the eye of all America, and your work at the Olympics for ABC, both in this country and abroad. and you caught the eyes of many people on the CBS Morning News. Isn't it a shame that you're not on television every day?
Well, I'm on next week.
That's right, June 14th.
Oh, that's right, June 14th.
Special on the NBC television
yeah,
network.
Yeah.
But isn't it a shame that you don't have a regular gig? I mean, I really think
it is. I mean, it was really tiring. I had to go do an early morning show here in Los Angeles today, and when I got up early, I can't believe I got up at 2:30 in the morning and did that for as long as I did. I didn't have a life. I didn't have a marriage. I was miserable. I was so unhappy. I didn't know I was successful or why. I just had no center. It was a terrible life. So if I ever did it again, I mean, I'm more centered now. But boy,
sure,
it's a grind.
Sure.
And you know it's a
sure,
really tough grind. As
sure,
you get older, you really go, I don't know about that.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
And the program on the 14th is people who have been famous for whatever reason, and we check back on them and see what they're doing now.
Everyone who had their 15 minutes.
You talked to some people on that program that were on the Tomorrow Show many times, and that is the DeBolts,
the
who have the 19 kids. Why don't you give, I think we have a little snippet of this, by the way, but give the crowd here an idea of who these remarkable people are and what they do.
Well, there was this a PBS documentary. It actually got an Academy Award called Who Are the DeBolts and Why Do They Have 19
yeah,
Kids?
Yeah, exactly right. Yeah,
and Henry Winkler anchored it, and it just caught everyone's eye, and it was so incredible because here this couple that remarried, or actually, you know, both of them had been married before,
right,
married each other later in life, and adopted what are called the unadoptables,
yep,
young children who were either paraplegic or handicapped in some way, you know, many from foreign countries.
Surely.
And like, what happened to those kids? So it's now 20 years later, and we check in.
And that's one of the things that you do.
Yeah, but it's great because we have the footage from them 20 years ago, and now that they're adults, they can talk about what it was like when they were six, and you can see them falling downstairs, and we talk about that now.
Yeah. And what's the title of this here program?
After the Headlines.
After the Headlines. Do we have some of this set up to go? Why don't we... Why don't you roll that? Hey, Tom, why not? It's your show.
Dorothy Atwood, a widow with nine kids, four of whom were adopted, married Bob DeBolt, a single parent with one child. Their family of 10 quickly increased to 19 as they added a rainbow of children to their brood. Some kids were war orphans. Some were physically challenged. But all of them were survivors who thrived thanks to Bob and Dorothy's encouragement. The world fell in love with the DeBolts, and in 1983, a second television special caught up with them as they grew older. Once the spotlight faded on their headline-making days, the DeBolts still face the incredible day-to-day physical and emotional challenges of their unique family. Over a decade later, where are the DeBolts?
The little one combing her hair was a little bit upset about something. I don't think she liked her pigtail or something. I saw a little temper there. It was cute.
Well, did you just see the little girl who was bouncing on the bed?
Oh, yeah.
Well, we check in with her, and she talks to us 20 years later. And when she has a child. And when you see her, she has no arms and no legs. And when you see her dress this little child with the stump putting that child's arms, it
tears your heart out, doesn't it?
I cried 3 to 4 times. When I saw the, I've cried so many times looking at that piece.
But
the whole show, I cry.
But they don't cry.
they don't cry.
And like, is there anybody in there who was famous for 15 minutes, like a celebrity, like something?
Oh,
like,
Faye Ray, for instance.
Oh, sure.
Well, Faye Ray, that was actually King Kong was her 77th movie.
You're kidding.
I didn't know that.
I thought it was,
you know,
one of her early efforts.
Yeah, and what was great for her this year is Steven Spielberg and the crew brought her back to Jurassic Park because apparently King Kong was an influence for their making
for
Jurassic
sake.
Park. So they put her on the set. And
how is Faye, by the way?
She's awesome.
Oh, yeah?
She's 87. She went up to the Empire State Building for us.
You're kidding.
Oh, she's so cheesy.
We ought to get her in here, you know?
Yeah. But there are a lot of those people that are going, what happened to them? Yeah, that's what this show's about.
That's on June 14th. That'll be on the NBC television network, and I hope it's the first of many assignments that you get from NBC, and know that you are always welcome here to chat about stuff.
So much fun being with you.
Well, thank you. Thank
are you single?
We'll answer these questions a little later on. We will continue, folks, with Argus Hambledon. We have actual newspapers here with headlines, and this laugh-a-minute guy will just roar us right up to Berkowitz. Now, these messages.